Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asian Newsline and here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 17th of April. BJP won't cross 150 seats, claims Congress leader Rahul Gandhi. IMF raises India's economic growth projection to 6.8%. And priests perform unique ritual in Ayodhya on birth anniversary of Lord Ram. And now for all the details. Launching a scathing attack over PM Modi's recent interview to ANI, opposition Congress Party leader Rahul Gandhi on Wednesday said that his remarks were scripted and it was a flop show. Commenting on Modi's statement on electoral bonds, bringing transparency in the system, Rahul Gandhi questioned the reason for which that system was cancelled by the apex court. He further claimed that BJP will not be able to cross the 150-seat mark in the upcoming electoral battle.
दुनिया का सबसे बड़ा एक्सटॉर्शन स्कैम इलेक्टोरल बॉन्ड्स है, इसीलिए इसको समझाते हुए प्रधानमंत्री के हाथ कांप रहे थे। कार ने कंपनियों को धमकाकर डराकर उनसे पैसे लिए हैं।
As general elections are around the corner, all political parties have intensified campaigning. PM Modi on Wednesday, in a gathering in Assam, highlighted his BJP government's commitment to inclusive development. He said, in just 10 years, he has accomplished what the Congress could not in 60 years. The general elections will be held in 7 stages, starting April 19 until June 1, with the results expected on 4th of June. The IMF's executive director and India's former chief economic advisor, Krishnamurthy V. Subramanian, on Tuesday heaped praise on India and said that the country will be a driver for global growth in the foreseeable future. The IMF on Wednesday raised India's growth forecast from 2024 to 25 to 6.8% from 6.5% on the back of strong domestic demand and a rising working age population. Subramanian noted that ever since the COVID-19 pandemic, India has witnessed consistent growth considering the current global economic situation. He predicted that India will have 8% growth in the fourth quarter. Lauding the digital infrastructure, he noted that even local vendors are accepting digital payments in India. India's GDP grew at a massive 8.4% during the October-December quarter of current financial year, and the country has continued to remain the fastest growing major economy.
In India, you know, pre-2014, productivity growth annually was 1.3%, the rate of productivity growth. In contrast, the rate of productivity growth post-2014 has been 2.7%. That is more than double. And I think that is a very important driver, you know, for growth to continue to be, you know, a high and for it to be sustainable going forward.
And reacting over India's Prime Minister Narendra Modi's statement regarding crossing borders to kill terrorists, the US State Department on Tuesday urged New Delhi and Islamabad to avoid escalation amid reports of killing of terrorists in Pakistan by unidentified individuals. A report by The Guardian alleged that India carried out multiple targeted assassinations in Pakistan. New Delhi has rejected the claims as false and malicious anti-India propaganda. Spokesperson for U.S. Department of State Matthew Miller in a press briefing said that U.S. won't get involved into the matter, but both the countries should find a resolution through dialogue. The relations between India and Pakistan have nosedived since 2019 after the terror attack on Indian military convoy in India's Jammu and Kashmir, which was traced to a Pakistan-based terror outfit. It prompted New Delhi to carry out an airstrike on a terror camp in Pakistan. Pakistan's financial capital, Karachi, is facing an alarming increase in street crimes, with residents worried for their safety. Locals have blamed it's the failure of the police, government and the judicial system, highlighting that criminals now rob people in broad daylight. A report.
Residents of Pakistan's financial capital, Karachi, have said they are worried over rising street crimes, while the law enforcement authorities in the city have failed to curb robberies, kidnappings and murders in broad daylight. The advent of 2024, according to official figures, has already witnessed killings of more than 50 people during mugging incidents. Experts believe the country's worsening economic crisis is forcing people to resort to unwanted crimes, and authorities have failed to act.
समझ नहीं आता कि कराची वाले अब फरियाद करें तो करें किससे, क्योंकि पहले भी कराची वाले जो है ये फरियाद करते रहे हैं कि उनके माल को लूटा जा रहा है, मगर अब तो बात जानों तक आ गई है और जाने भी जो हैं वो दर्जन दो दर्जन जाने जो हैं वो सिर्फ मोबाइल स्नैचिंग के अंदर जा चुकी हैं। इसके अलावा डकैती मुजाहमत को भी इसके अंदर अगर हम शामिल कर लें दीगर चीज़ों में तो भी 10-15 जाने जा चुकी हैं। तो यहाँ पर बात वही आती है कि कराची के अंदर जो कम्युनिटी पुलिसिंग है उसके अंदर इजाफा करने की ज़रूरत है। इसके अलावा जो पुलिसिंग का मेयार है उसको भी मजीद बेहतर किया जाना चाहिए। पुलिस के अंदर भी जो इक्विपमेंट्स हैं उनको जदीद फराहम किए जाने चाहिए।
सम रेजिडेंट्स आल्सो चूज नॉट टू अप्रोच पुलिस ड्यू टू लैक ऑफ ट्रस्ट एंड नो होप ऑफ एक्शन। In the latest, local media on Wednesday reported that the Sindh government has opted to replace Karachi's police chief over the law and order situation.
Moving on, Sri Lanka on Tuesday rejected international bondholders' proposal to restructure more than $12 billion in debt, putting at risk critical IMF support and delaying its effort to resolve a two-year-long debt crisis. Some of the proposal's baseline assessments and a lack of a contingency option in the case of continued economic weakness were the two main reasons the deal was not agreed, the government said in a statement. Colombo said it hoped to hold further talks as soon as feasible, but the immediate risk was that without a compromise in the coming weeks, the next tranche of all important IMF support money could potentially get delayed. Sri Lanka has already struck a deal with its main government creditors, but an agreement in principle with bondholders was also needed to secure the next $337 million installment of its $2.9 billion IMF bailout. Supported by the IMF program, Sri Lanka has seen its once soaring inflation moderate to 0.9% in March and its currency strengthen 7.6% so far this year.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.